they looped that that play in the first half for LeBron when Looney was on his arm and he finished his left. Did that remind you of yourself when you were a player a little bit?
No. It's impressive. He's an impressive player. But I was most impressed with the pace we played with the first half. You know, I think it showed what we're capable of as a team, if we run as a team, you know, because we were taking the ball out. It didn't matter who it was getting thrown ahead to. We were attacking the rim and putting pressure on their defense. So that'll continue to get better, especially as we continue to get better at defense. But that was my favorite part of the first half was the pace we played with.
That was the first time you've had your whole actual unit, right, with Lonzo being able to come in, and he came in early with the fouls. So what do you think was the reason, though, overall, you were able to get to that pace you've been looking to get to?
It takes effort and commitment. You know, you got to be... you have to want to play at that pace. And we had a commitment from everyone on our team before training camp that that's who we're going to be. So obviously every night's not going to look like that, but I think it was a good visual for the guys to see what we're capable of when we take the ball out of the net quickly and throw it ahead, when we get stops and we're looking ahead instead of just dribbling it up ourselves. We had a lot of dangerous weapons that can attack the rim.
Ingram got to the foul line 17 times tonight, I think 15 against Sacramento. What does that do for you, and what does that do for his game?
Well, it's nice, obviously, as you know, to be a great scorer in this league, you got to be a pretty good free throw shooter, and you got to get to the line a lot. So we're encouraging him to be aggressive, but we also need him, you know, to continue to move the ball. You know, when the defense has done a good job of loading up, but he gets to the line like that, he's a very good player.
Lonzo had 4 steals defensively. He was pretty good last year as a rookie. Do you think that was a help tonight, or what was the reason the defense was generally a little better?
Well, we fouled way too much in the first quarter. Second quarter, we did a much better job of keeping him off the line. So, you know, that's the number one thing. We want to play aggressive defense, but we can't just foul. And you know, I think when I called the first time out, Steph had already shot 6 free throws, and they were 7 for 8 or 8 for 9, something like that. So we have to defend without fouling, but we also want to be aggressive, and we want to go for steals and get deflections. We feel like that's the strength of our team, as you know, opposed to being, you know, just more of the solid defensive rotations. We want to get after people. And Zoe did a nice job of getting some of that for us tonight.
Overall, what did you think of
Zoe? I thought he was good. Yeah, like I said, going into the game, I just was excited to get him out there getting reps with his teammates against other people. And I thought as the game went on, he got more comfortable, made more plays, and it was good to have him out there.
What did you see with him and Rondo together?
I liked it. That's something, you know, it's happening pretty quick. But I love having multiple ball handlers, playmakers on the floor. When we're running our pistol actions and our dribble drags and not really mattering, you know, who brings it up, who's getting it thrown ahead to, you trust the guy that has the ball in his hands and good things are going to happen. So I'm going to check it out on film, but my first thought on it was that it looked good.
Luke, what are some of your favorite memories of Tex Winter?
Of Tex? Tex used to always try to get me in the game. I love Tex. He'd sit on the bench because he was all about fundamentals. And, you know, I was talking to Steve about it a little bit too, and we were just saying how much we guys like us owe our entire playing career to Tex and people like that really teach the game. And he lived an amazing life, and he'll be missed. And I'm just grateful I got to spend some time with him and learn from him. But he was an amazing man.
Luke, back in July, we had asked you about Jonathan Williams, and you hadn't had a chance to see him. Now through most of the preseason, whether he ends up on the roster starting tonight or with South Bay, can you just talk about his progression?
He's been great. He's the perfect example of what hard work can get you. You know, he's not out there scoring a lot, but he talks on defense. He makes the right rotations. He's in the gym working every day, and he's earned the trust of not just his coaches, but of his teammates. His teammates love playing with him, and they root for him when he gets his chances. So
obviously, you guys are working on stuff in the preseason, but how about LeBron with the showmanship to the fans here in Las Vegas that don't get a chance to see the Lakers play, the pass and the shot that he hit right before the half?
LeBron about the way he played tonight?
Yeah, he was putting on a show for the most part for Laker fans here in Las Vegas that don't get a chance to see the Lakers.
I mean, I don't, yeah. I think his motivation is bigger than that. I know he wants, you know, he always wants to show well for the, you know, for fans. He appreciates what they mean to our game. But our season starts in a week. So I think it was also, more of, you know, let's continue to tune this thing up and make sure that we're taking advantage of our opportunities.
The foul calls are waiting for you this time, but still, are you concerned about the number and
yeah.
the overall flow?
There's a lot of fouls being called, and it's the refs are being told to call those. So it's a lot. I'll leave it at that. It's a lot right now.
A couple of games ago, you mentioned overpassing. Are you starting to see that trend towards the right direction?
Yeah, we're okay with overpassing for now because we know that'll get cleaned up and guys will start to recognize as they play more with each other the type of shots we want when that rhythm shot comes to you to take it. And tonight, it was definitely better than it was a few games ago. And we still had a couple possessions where that ball was flying up the court with zero dribbles, and that's who we want to be.
What was helping Casey get those better quality looks tonight as opposed to prior games?
Well, he did a nice job of knocking down, so I'm getting to the free throw line. But it's about the pace, and he's done a great job of committing. You know, we want that first wing running deep corner every time. And when you're playing as a shooter and you got guys like LeBron and Ingram and Rondo pushing the ball down the middle, the defense has to collapse. And because KCP is doing his work early and getting to that deep corner, he's able to get some clean looks.
How did Hart come through the game with this injury?
He was great. He wanted to go back in, said he didn't feel anything, but I predetermined before the game I was going to give him one long run, and that was it.